Hi, very good morning. This is JM, E4 Physics faculty. The last few series, video series, there we discussed hydrostatics and part 1, part 2 and its related theory and problems. Now in this lecture we are going to discuss hydrodynamics theory part. The content sheet, for your reference, the content sheet is here. So in that we are going to discuss the following topics, subtopics, what they are listed there. So now we please start our session. So the first one is equation of continuity. So the first subheading is equation of continuity. Yes, continuity. So what is equation of continuity? It is based on, first thing is, it is based on mass conservation. Mass conservation, okay, that means total for mass of the fluid is conserved. So let us consider there is a tube of a different area of cross section. Say this is area 2 and this is area of cross section 1. The velocity of the fluid is taken as to be v2 here, and this is taken as to be v1, and you just assume that your non-viscous fluid is going there. So in this case, the amount of the fluid enter here is same as to be here also. Therefore, by this concept, mass conservation, we can write m1 is equal to m2. Yes. So mass is generally nothing but density into volume. So rho 1 v1, this is volume. Yes. So rho 1 v1, that is equal to rho 2 v2. Generally, since we assume that it is a non-viscous fluid and incompressible non-viscous fluid, their density will be same throughout this as a flow. Therefore, I can write that this has to be rho v1, that is equal to rho v2. And so therefore, we can get volume 1 is equal to volume 2. That is, volume of the fluid enter here is equal to volume of the fluid exists there. So volume can be written as area into distance. So say for example a1 into sx, that is equal to a2 into x. But you just see that velocity equal to distance by time. If time is taken as to be 1 unit, then we can say that v is equal to x. So instead of this x, I can write that that has to be v1 and v2. Therefore a1 v1, that is equal to a2 v2. So this is the, so please be careful with the symbol. This is volume and here this one is velocity. So in general it can be written as to be, that is equal to constant, or I can generalize that AV, that is product of area and velocity, equal to constant. That is called the equation of continuity, or in this I can say that V is inversely proportional to area. So this equation is often used in the upcoming topics. Now we please go for the second one, volume flux. Now you see that the second subheading is volume flux. Volume flux, so that is nothing but Q, that is equal to volume of the fluid, volume divided by time. So rate of volume flow. So therefore we can say that volume is nothing but, just now we wrote that as a volume. Volume is nothing but A1 V1. You can take this one. Volume is directly as taken as to be area into velocity. Therefore, I can write that that is area into velocity. So therefore, Q is equal to volume by time, that is equal to area into velocity. So this is called volume flux. And a unit and all, you know that there is meter square, meter per second. From that you can get meter cube by second inverse. Okay. So next one is three types of energy in fluids. Now you see that whenever a fluid is moving, so it has some velocity, therefore kinetic energy will be there. Suppose if you consider this has to be our reference line, then we can say that the position of this end is at an height h1 and this will be at an height h2. So definitely the potential energy, gravitational potential energy will be there. And we know that for liquid flow, there will be a pressure difference from one point to another point. If you move the liquid, we must apply the external pressure. So due to that, work done by the pressure for S is considered to be pressure energy. Therefore, three types of energy is there. So the first one is, I can write that has to be, first one is kinetic energy. So Ek, or simply K, that is our wish, can be written as half mv square. This is velocity, we know that. So R, the same can be written as, now you please see that mass can be written as density into volume. So this can be written as density into volume. Yes. So please be careful with the symbol, as even though the notations are very similar, you take care of that. This is volume, that is velocity. And energy by volume is nothing but energy density. Therefore, yes, energy density. So energy density. Energy density is nothing but energy by volume. Energy by volume, the remaining term is rho into velocity square. Again, if the same equation is divided by weight, that is mg, if it is divided by weight mg, then the same equation can be written as kinetic energy. Kinetic energy K is equal to, just divide that one is mg. So if you are divided by mg, then we can get v square by 2g. This is called velocity head. So whenever the energy of the liquid is divided by weight, then the term gives the head, velocity head here. This is velocity head. So now you see that the second type of energy is potential energy. So therefore, potential energy. So gravitational potential energy. So potential energy, say for example, that is U. And generally you know that U is equal to mgh. Again, as I said, mass is nothing but density into volume. So that can be written as density into volume into gh. And energy by volume is nothing but energy density. Therefore, energy density, gravitational energy density, that is equal to U by volume. Volume, that is equal to, yes, rho gh, rho gh. And again, as I said earlier, if the first equation is divided by weight mg, then we can get that has to be, yes, that is called pressure, sorry, gravitational head. So that is gravitational, yes, head. So that is this gravitational head. The general head is getting by, yes, dividing that weight of the fluid mg. So you just divide it by that, you will get h. Now the third type of energy is now you please see the third type of energy, that is pressure energy. So pressure energy, say for example EP. So that is given by EP is equal to pressure into volume. Pressure into volume. So whenever energy is divided by volume, then you will get the energy density, pressure energy density. So that is equal to energy by volume. Pressure energy by volume, that is nothing but P. Again, as I said, so the same equation can be written as P into volume, can be written as mass by density. So volume can be written as mass by density. If the same equation is divided by mg, then I can get that has to be pressure head. So pressure head. So pressure head, that is nothing but you just divide that equation by mg, then I can get P by rho g. This is pressure head. So these are the three types of energy possessed by a liquid. Therefore, I can give the total energy. So I can give the total energy of the fluid. So E total is nothing but sum of all these energies. You can either add that first equation, or you can add for the energy density or velocity head, whatever may be that. But I'm just going with the general one. Therefore, half mv square plus mgh plus pv, or this equation, the another equation may be used for some other purpose. So that is energy density. So I can write that is for total energy density. So total energy density, that is equal to half rho v square plus rho gh plus p is there. So this equation we will use it, or this equation also we can use it if we need it. So this is the total energy in a fluid. Next you see that Bernoulli's theorem. So go for the next slide, Bernoulli's theorem. Now you please see that in Bernoulli's theorem we can see that so the theorem states that for the incompressible non-viscous streamline flow, this condition is very important for the validity of Bernoulli's theorem. So the next topic is, this is the total energy. So this is third topic, and next is a fourth one. So, okay, so Bernoulli's theorem. So Bernoulli's theorem. So the conditions are very important here. So I can write that conditions. So what is the condition means for a non-viscous? What is that viscous? That and all we discussed, non-viscous and incompressible. So incompressible and streamline flow, that and all we will discuss when we discuss the Reynolds number. So streamlined motion or flow. for this fluid or liquid, the total energy is conserved. So this is the condition. So condition needed or condition. So condition for this. And based what is the basic concept behind that one is energy conservation. So energy conservation. Okay. So energy conservation is the basic thing. So from this we can say that the Bernoulli's theorem for this given condition. So non-viscous incompressible streamline flow of the SF fluid. The total energy of the SF fluid is conserved. Therefore E total or in terms of energy density I can write that U total as we wrote here, that is equal to S of rho V square S plus rho GH plus P, that is equal to constant. That is equal to constant, yes. So now that is the thing. But when you consider this diagram, which is the derivation for Bernoulli's theorem, but MCQ point of view, I'm not going to derive that the derivation. I'm just explain that. Just see that there are ends are there. That first end one. So pressure, area, everything is mentioned at the point A, and that another end that is mentioned has to be is a second point B. Their datas are given, pressure P2, area and that and all is given. So for that case, for this given diagram, we can write that Bernoulli's theorem for as a terminal A and the terminal B. So the same equation can be rewritten as to be like this. Therefore, for that I can write that between the points A and B. So even though they are using small a1, so you can use it either capital A or small a, that is our wish. So therefore, at end a1, therefore I can write that half rho v1 square plus rho g h1 plus p1. This is the total energy at the end a, that is equal to total energy at end b, that is rho v2 square plus rho g h2 plus p2. Or in general I can write that the total energy has to be constant. Suppose you just see the diagram, that is the special case. Suppose if the tube is horizontal, then I can say that h1 is equal to h2. So this gravitational term gets cancelled out, that the remaining term is half rho v1 square plus p1, that is equal to half rho v2 square plus p2. These are velocity v2 square. Or in general I can write that half rho v square plus p has to be constant. So this is the main equation where we can use the two things we can get it from this. So in equation of continuity, when area increases velocity will be decreases. This is these two results we are often used for the torus isla and venturi meter. So when area increases, speed of the fluid is decreases. Here just see that. So just correlate this. So here, so this is the very important point of what we have to be keep in mind. According to equation of continuity, when area increases velocity will be decreases. So since the total energy is constant, when the velocity decreases the pressure of the fluid is increases. So when velocity decreases pressure of the fluid flow will be increases. So this is the very important point for the derivations of the upcoming topics. So go for the next slide. Before that, you please take down this theory part for your reference. Now you see that now we are going to discuss the applications of Bernoulli's theorem. In NCERT book they are given many applications, but in exam point of view these two are very very important. One is Venturi meter and another one is Torricelli's law. The very basic thing you must just keep in mind that the last part what we wrote there, so that is from the equation of continuity. So now I am going to discuss applications of Bernoulli's theorem, just a short form I am writing, don't confuse with that. So now you please see that the two things you can keep in mind. The first one is equation of continuity, so area into velocity has to be constant, and another result is when area is more the velocity will be less. From the Bernoulli's theorem, that is the general equation, that is half rho v1 square or half rho v square plus rho gh plus p, that is equal to constant. There we said that when velocity increases, so here we said that when velocity increases, so or when velocity decreases the pressure of the liquid will be increases and vice versa. So this is the two important thing what we must keep in mind for the discussion of these topics. So now we please see that and the first diagram. So first I am going to explain the or derive the expression based on the first diagram, then we can go for the second one. So here alone I will do the derivation, because for problem solving purpose we must know how to apply Bernoulli's theorem in the problem solving process. So now we consider the diagram. There are two ends are there, just to see that there is a position point 1 and point 2 will be there. I am taking the area of cross section at the point 1 is A1 and the corresponding pressure is P1 and velocity is V1, and similarly there, so V2 is velocity and area A2 and the pressure is P2. Now you please see that, so I am writing Bernoulli's theorem and you see that. So Bernoulli's theorem, write the Bernoulli's theorem at the points 1 and 2. I can write that at this point region 1, therefore half rho V1 square plus, since the tube is horizontal, so there is no term for H1 and H2 because that will cancel out. So in this case we must keep in the mind that here H1 equal to H2, so therefore there is no this term, gravitational potential energy term will not exist here. Therefore half rho V1 square plus P1, that is equal to, this is the total energy at the region 1, and for region 2 I can write that half rho V2 square plus P2. Yes, the difference in, now you please see the diagram, you must understand area according to equation of continuity, that the area A1 is greater, therefore the corresponding velocity is less. So area is greater, A1 is greater, so A1 is greater than A2, therefore we can say that V1 is lesser than V2. When velocity decreases, corresponding pressure will be increases, therefore P1 is greater than P2. So this is the thing. So therefore, I can write P1 minus P2. So therefore, P1 minus P2, that is equal to, P1 minus P2, that is equal to half rho is common. So V2 square minus V1 square, just rewrite in the term. But here you must be very careful. What this rho is, the liquid flowing through the tube. So liquid in tube, sorry, okay, so that is the thing. Now in this case, but here we know that the manometer is used for, yes, in last lectures I said that the manometers are used for pressure difference or gauge pressure. So this is given by H rho m. What is rho m means? Density of the manometer liquid. So this is the thing you must keep in mind. So which will makes the difference between this diagram and the second diagram. So H rho m, manometer liquid density into G, that is equal to half rho into, I am taking V1 outside, therefore I can get V2 by V1, that whole square minus 1 into V1 square. So now you see that our aim is to find out the main purpose of the Venturi meter is to find either volume flux or velocity. So velocity of the fluid, that is the main thing for purpose for using that. Therefore I can write V1 square, so therefore V1 square, that is equal to, before that, since we know that yes, A1 V1, that is equal to A2 V2, from this when volume, we know that velocity, when velocity and the yes, from this equation of continuity we can say that velocity is inversely proportional, therefore V2 by V1 is nothing but yes, A1 by A2, inversely proportional. So therefore I can replace this term simultaneously, therefore just keep that V1 square in one side, and this term will come to denominator, therefore I can write that, so 2 also cross multiply that, or you can keep here itself to avoid the confusion. So half rho V1 square, that is equal to H rho M G divided by, this term is coming down, so that is V2 by V1, that is nothing but A1 by A2. So A1 by A2 that whole square minus 1, yes. So now you take this term to numerator, and meantime you please cross multiply this. I can get V1 square is equal to 2 rho rho M Hg divided by density of the liquid flow. So density of the liquid flow, that is A1 by A2 that whole square minus 1. And if you take the square root of that, we can get the expression, or I can write that also for your reference. So therefore, or I can say that V1 is equal to square root of 2 rho manometer liquid density height difference into G divided by density of the liquid flow in the tube. When you take this term to numerator, it becomes to be minus 1 by 2. So when you take the square root and meanwhile you are taking to the numerator, there I can write that has to be so A1 by A2 that whole square minus 1 minus 1 by 2. So this is the required expression for the velocity of the fluid flow. Suppose we know that the volume flux Q is equal to A1 V1, for example A1 V1. So therefore by multiplying this with A1, we can get the volume flux of the moving fluid. Now you please see the second one. The first diagram, that U-shaped tubes are used, that is called a differential manometer, which measure the pressure difference. Okay. So now you see the second diagram. There are two tubes are there, that is called a simple manometer. Simple manometer used there. In that cases, what is the main difference between the first diagram and second one is, there we are using manometer liquid. But there in the second diagram, that manometer, instead of manometer liquid, the flowing fluid itself raises the tube, inside the tube. Therefore, in that case, so for the second diagram, this is for the equations when differential manometer, that is U-shaped manometer is used. Differential or U-shaped manometer is used, that time we can use this expression. Suppose we just see the second one, that is called for a simple manometer. Simple manometer, which contains only two vertical tubes, where that liquid in the vertical tube is same as to be the liquid flowing through the given tube. Therefore, these two densities are same. So they are gets cancelled out. In this case, these two densities are same. So rho is equal to rho manometer. Therefore, I can write that V1 is equal to root of 2GH into A1 by A2 that whole square minus 1 power 1 by 2. So these are the two main results, are important results. And meantime, I hope that you learnt how to use the Bernoulli's theorem for the problem solving or doing the problem. Now you please go for the second application. That is called the Torricelli's law. So Torricelli's law is another application of the Bernoulli's equation or theorem. But here also, as we said in the content sheet, here also two cases are there. One is the top end is closed and another one is top end is open. Since here we explained how to do the derivation or application of the Bernoulli theorem, here also, since in hydrodynamics the problem part is these two are very, very important. So for that purpose I'm going to the second application, so that is nothing but Torricelli's law. First case, top end is closed. Now you please see that, so the case one, what I am going to discuss is top end is closed, top is closed, Now you please see that in this case, so this will be torricellis law. Torricellis law. Yes, or velocity of a flux or speed of a flux. Now please see that again the same thing. You consider the two point and you apply the Bernoulli's theorem. So two points are there. That is, two is there and one is there. So therefore, first I am going to write A1 V1 that is equal to A2 V2. Equation of continuity, first step. And another step is you have to apply the or write the Bernoulli's equation for 1 and 2. Since just see the diagram here, you can say that since V2 is nearly 0, what is the thing is, since A2 is very very large. Just now we said that velocity from the equation of continuity, yes, velocity and area are inversely proportional. So when area is very large and velocity will be very less, so it is approximated here has to be 0 since area is greater than, A2 is greater than A1. So therefore, now you apply the Bernoulli's theorem in the region 1 and 2. So I can write that. So in region 2, I can write that the same equation as what we discussed in this. So therefore, here, that is this equation, because here gravitational term will not get cancelled out. Yes, so this is the general equation we must keep in or remember. Half rho V square plus rho G H. Generally, this is not a small h. Generally, as a h we have taken there, rho gh plus p equal to constant. This is the general formula what we are going to use here. So now we see that for point 2, I can write the same equation of rho v2 square plus rho g. The total height of the liquid from bottom of the container is taken as to be capital H. So rho g capital H plus the pressure is p2 with that. Since there we assume that V2 has to be 0, so this term will not be exist because here, because of the greater area of cross section, velocity is approximated as 0. Therefore, this term is becomes 0. Now, we please see that the second part 1 for the point 1, there we can write half rho V1 square plus rho G. From the bottom of the container, the position 1 is at a height H minus H. Therefore, H minus H plus yes, P2. So now you see that equation here, rho gh is there, plus rho gh, it is taken to this side, minus rho gh, it gets cancelled out. Therefore, P2 is equal to half rho V1 square. You just multiply that minus rho g small h is there. So, and plus P1, yes, this is P1, as P1, so this is P1. Now you please write, so P2 minus P1, that is equal to half rho into V1 square, is P2 minus P1, that is minus rho gh. So from this, I can write that half rho V1 square, that is equal to rho gh plus P2 minus P1. Now please, our aim is to find out what is V1. So V1 square is equal to, yes, just divided by that. Then 2gh plus, just multiply, so 2 into P2 minus P1 divided by rho. So this is the velocity equation for the first case when the top end is closed. This is the way how to apply Bernoulli's theorem also. As I said, for problem solving purpose, you must learn or you must practice how to use the Bernoulli's equations and the equation of continuity. Now you please see that. So when this is for the case when a top end is closed. Okay. So now for that, when top end is open. So in that cases here also, since the terminal 1 is in direct contact with the atmosphere, here also P1 is equal to P atmosphere only. But in the second case, here P2 is equal to P1. When the top end is open, please see the second diagram, it is in direct contact with the atmosphere. Therefore, P2 is equal to P1, that is equal to P atmosphere. Yes. So for that reason, if you are putting that P1 is equal to P2 equal to P atmosphere, then this term becomes 0. Therefore, I can get that V1 square is equal to 2GH. From this, V1 is equal to square root of 2gh. So there are two case equations for here. So just to keep in mind. And from this second case, we are going to get some important results. Yes. So just to see the diagram. This velocity is the velocity of the liquid coming from the end one. So therefore, I can say that this is the ground level, and this is the position of that point one, which is at an height h minus h. So this is the direction of velocity v1, which is equal to square root of 2gh. Therefore, it is falling down like this, which is very similar to, in kinematics we studied that it is very similar to horizontal projection from a certain height, and this will be the corresponding range. So for that I can say that this is very similar to horizontal projection from a certain height. Therefore, time of flight, so time of flight, that is a time taken to reach the fluid from this point to here. Therefore, TF, that is nothing but square root of 2 into h minus h divided by g. Yes, so this is the time of flight taken by the fluid. And similarly, range, so range of the projection, we are similarly here also, range is equal to horizontal velocity into time taken for that, that is v1 into TF. And you just write here, or I can write that v1, so v1 is nothing but s square root of 2gh into TF is nothing but square root of 2 into capital H minus small h divided by g. We know that in mathematics we have studied that for any function dr by dh, to find the maximum range dr by dh, because h is a variable, I can put the hole at any height from the as a free surface. So therefore, for r max, so for r max, the first derivative should be 0. So by solving this, we can get small h is equal to capital H by 2. When you make the hole at the middle, that means at an height h is equal to h by 2, then r becomes to r max, that value is equal to capital H. So this is the another important results. And one more equation result is there for this case, I can write there. So that is that. So time taken, so time taken to empty the tank, suppose that we are assuming that the hole is made at the S bottom. So this our point one is considered to be here. So this is the region one and this is region two. So in this case, time taken to empty the tank is T empty. Time taken to empty the tank, that is equal to S 2 into S A 2. So that is, I can say that here instead of using that A 2, A 1, I can use that as to be A large and A small. A large and the A small. So I can say that has to be A 2. So we can say that is A large divided by A small. So here A large, as per the diagram here, that will be A2, and as per the diagram this has to be A1. So into square root of 2H by G. So this is the time taken to empty the tank when it is hole is made at the bottom of the container. So these are the very elaborate thing for your understanding purpose. Yes, the elaborate detailed explanations are given. Kindly note it down and we can move for the next concept. Kindly note it down. Now we please go for the another topic in hydrodynamics. So that is nothing but viscosity and Newton's formula. And we know that in mechanics, we studied that whenever two surfaces are in relative motion, there will be a contact force exist. There are two kind of contact force. One is normal contact force, is mechanics is called a normal reaction, and another one is a tangential contact force, that is called friction. So what is viscosity means? It is the property of the liquid whenever there is a relative motion between, just see the diagram, whenever there is a relative motion between the layers, the liquid flow is considered to be successive layers one over another. Whenever there is a flow, a relative motion between the layers of the fluid, there is a friction between the two layers or the layers which are in contact, that will arise as some opposing force, that is called viscous force. So that is the one of the basic property for any liquid, viscosity. Now I am going to write the Newton's formula there. So we see that. So the next topic is viscosity. Next topic is viscosity. The first one is, due to the relative motion between the layers of the fluid, there is a opposing force or damping force or resistive force, that is called a viscous force. From Newton's formula, Newton says that the viscous force is directly proportional to area of cross section of the layers velocity gradient dv by dx, or I can write that F is equal to some proportionality constant, and I can use negative sign here. This is the opposing force which opposes the motion of the fluid, therefore minus eta A into dv by dx. Now that eta is nothing but coefficient of viscosity. So coefficient of viscosity. So coefficient of viscosity is SI unit is poise. Yes, so now you see that another one, that is called velocity profile. Since whenever there is a fluid flow, so this is the Newton's formula. I don't want to write the topics because I am going in this order only, but anyway, for your reference, I will be right. So now you see that velocity profile. Now you see that this is the liquid flow, and whenever you consider the successive layers, the layers which are in contact with the solid surface, their velocity will be zero because there is a more resistive force due to the adhesive force between the liquid and the solid surface, or the liquid and the content, the tube. But when you are going towards the axis of the tube, when compared to this region, that resistive force is less, therefore the corresponding velocity will be increases as shown. Yes. Now this pattern or the velocity is a flow inside the liquid is denoted as written as to be velocity flux, and that has to be velocity profile. Now we see that there is a minimum resistive force, therefore we can get that maximum velocity V max, and at any distance this is taken as to be small r, and total radius of the tube is taken as to be capital R. Then the velocity of the profile is given by V is equal to that can be either delta P or P, that is our wish. If you are considering any two point, we can say that this is point P1 and some other point P2, then we can say that has to be L, and we can say that pressure difference has to be delta P, or at any point we can write, either you can use delta P or delta, that is our wish. So I can write that this may be either delta X or we can take that has to be L, that is our wish. So therefore I can write that P divided by 4 eta L, or if you are measuring between the two points, you can use the delta also, no issue, that is equal to R square minus small r square. When small r is equal to capital R, at this point when small r equal to capital R, the same is down also, we can say that. So then when small r equal to capital R, this equation becomes 0, at the axis small r equal to 0, then we can get V max is equal to delta P R square divided by 4 eta L. This is the velocity of the profile. Now you go for the next topic. Yes, as a Stokes formula. So from the experimental observation, Stokes gave the formula for the viscous force acts on the any solid which is moving in a highly viscous liquid. So this is the solid of density rho, and this is the fluid of our liquid of density sigma. When the solid is going down or moving in this fluid, then the viscous force or damping force, This is the direction of motion. The damping force is, or viscous force is, always in upward direction. So F viscous, that is equal to 6 pi eta, and I can give that radius as to be r, is a radius of the S. So the corresponding radius has to be r. I can take that has to be capital R here. So r into Vt. So this is the Stokes formula. So Stokes formula. So Stokes formula for the discussion. So now you see the next one. Yes, terminal velocity. Just for your understanding purpose, the diagram has given has to be three parts. When you just drop the solid sphere near the free surface of the liquid, the damping force is zero when time t equal to zero, because it begins to go down inside the liquid. When time increases, then what will happen means the value of damping force as well as the upward buoyancy force will come into the play. So therefore, so terminal velocity. Terminal velocity, so that is nothing but at equilibrium. At equilibrium means we know that in mechanics we studied that for translational equilibrium total force will be zero. So now you see that when total force is zero, the net upward force, buoyancy as well as viscous force, and this is force due to gravity, that is nothing but weight W. So this is F viscous, and this is the solid sphere, and the liquid is there. Yes, just to see that. So the net upward force equal to net downward force, therefore F gravity, or that is nothing but weight of the solid sphere, that is equal to F buoyancy plus F viscous force. By solving this, we can get that terminal velocity is equal to 2 by 9 eta, where eta is the coefficient of viscosity, g into r square, where r is a radius of the solid sphere, and rho minus sigma. So when you see that, when rho is lesser than sigma, that is when the solid density is less than the liquid density, velocity will be negative. That means the particle will, or the that material will move upward direction. For example, air bubbles in water. Now I can draw the graph for velocity versus either time or distance traveled. Time or distance traveled from the free surface of the liquid to here, that is a distance traveled, or time taken to travel this distance x, then I can draw the graph. It will be like this. At a particular time, say some time t, we can get that the velocity became has to be vt, that is the terminal velocity or constant velocity. Now we go for the another topic. So now another topic, Reynolds number. So the Reynolds number is used to distinguish the type of flow. So the Reynolds number is defined as Reynolds number, which is used to define the nature of the flow, to indicate the nature of the flow. So now you see that nr, or Reynolds number nr, is given by rho v d divided by eta, or that is equal to F inertial force, that is ma, divided by F viscous force, that is either you can use this one or 6 pi eta v. So therefore viscous force. Yes, from this explanation of the symbols are given. This is density of the fluid, velocity of the fluid, and diameter of the tube, and viscosity of the fluid. So nr lying between 0 to 2000, the flow is called a streamline flow. Streamline flow, where all the points are having same velocity and follow the same direction or path. Between 2000 to 3000, we cannot predict what kind of flow, whether it is neither turbulent or streamline. Turbulent or streamline, yes. So turbulent or streamline, we cannot predict. The motion is unsteady. Therefore, if it is more than 3000 or more than 3000, then that is a turbulent flow. So turbulent flow is where the velocity is and at a particular point will be different, and the path of the particle also different. Now we go for the another topic. So that is a Poiseuille's equation, the another important results for the is in hydrodynamics. Poiseuille's equation Poiseuille's equation, which will give the volume flux. So I can consider that has to be hydrocurrent for the comparison with the electricity, that is Q, that is nothing but volume by time. Yes, so volume by time, that is nothing but pi into, you just see the diagram, So pi into s delta p r power 4 divided by 8 eta l. This is the s Poiseuille's equation, where delta p is the pressure difference between the two ends. Yes. Now we see that in this case, the same equation can be rewritten. Therefore, IH that is equal to S Q. I can assume that has to be as a fluid current. Instead of hydro current, I can take that has to be fluid current. So fluid current. Yes, you just take that has to be fluid current. That is I is equal to, I can rearrange the term, delta P divided by S 8 eta L divided by pi R power 4. I can make the analogy or a comparison between the S hydrodynamics with the current electricity. From Ohm's law, we can say that S current I is equal to potential difference divided by resistance. So please be careful with the symbol. So here I am using small r. Therefore, I can use here also, sorry, this is a small r, because be careful with the symbol, small r is nothing but radius, but here this is a resistance, be careful with that symbols. So by comparing this, I can say that this term is play the same role as that of the fluid resistance. So therefore, I can compare these two as electric potential difference, electrical potential difference is same as to be pressure difference, electrical resistance is same as to be as a fluid resistance. Therefore, R fluid resistance is equal to 8 eta L divided by pi R power 4. Is to find the unit, I am giving that work has to be as for your self practice for to find out this, because you are familiar with the units and measurements. So now you see that I can reformulate this equation. Therefore, the fluid current is equal to pressure difference divided by resistance, which is very similar to your Ohm's law for electricity. So based on this comparison or analogy, we can make the resistor parallel and the resistor series there, and most of them are very familiar with that. This is the resistance, say R1, R2. In series combination, we know that current I is same, but their potentials are different. So therefore, total potential is V1 plus V2. And in this case, you just see that children, in series combination, we said that I will be same. Current is same, but the potential is different. V, potential difference is different. So for parallel combinations, there we said that this is R1 and R2. So R1 and this has to be R2. Here this is I1 and this will be I2, and total current I is coming, summing that. So in this case, for parallel combination, we said that V same, potential difference is the same, but I will be different, okay. The same analogy here I am going to take, and for your reference, the diagram is given for the series combination and the parallel combination of the tube. So here I can take that combination of the tube. For series combination, as we said, I has to be constant. The comparison between electric current and this one is nothing but either Q or you can term it as to be IF, but I can take this as to be Q also. So Q is nothing but volume flux, or for our convenience we can say that is fluid current. Therefore Q is same, as here we said current is same, Q is same, but potential is different here in series. Here the same role is played by pressure. Therefore P is different. And in this case, parallel combination of the tube, I can say that Q will be different and P is same. So P will be same. Yes, now you see that. Therefore, as we did here, we know that RS is equal to R1 plus R2 and 1 by RP that is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Therefore, the same analogy I can say that R series equal to R1 plus R2, where R1, R2 represents the fluid resistance. So similarly, 1 by RP that is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, R represents the fluid resistance here. So this is the application of Bernoulli's theorem, and series and parallel combination of the tube. Now we go for the another concept. Yeah, so in this, you just see that factors affecting viscosity. So please take down the notes. So now you see that last one, that is a factor affecting is viscosity. So for your understanding purpose, I can draw the flow chart here. That is, one is for is liquid, or I can say that is liquid, and another one is for fluid gases. So another one is for gas. For your reference, I can say that. So now you see that there are three main parameters which are going to affect that. That is for temperature, and next one is pressure, and next one is density of the liquid. So density. So I can write that has to be density. So density rho. So this is P, and this is for temperature T. So here also the same parameter we are going to is write, that is temperature T, is pressure P, and density rho. So when temperature increases due to the weakening of intermolecular forces, so the viscosity gets reduced. Therefore, I can say that we can say that as the temperature increases, viscosity of the liquid will decreases. Here, just opposite of that, when pressure increases, viscosity also increases, because we are going to discuss in thermal properties. There, the behavior of water is slightly different from other liquids. Therefore, we can say that except water. So now you see that in densities, so when density of the liquid increases, heat also will increase. Just opposite to here, we can say that, yeah, so just opposite of this. So when temperature increases, heat will decreases. It's just a reverse of that, and opposite. When temperature increases, yes, heat also gets increases. Just opposite of this, for memory hint, I can say that when pressure increases, eta will, yes, decrease, and when density of the gas increases, when rho increases, eta will decrease. And for your reference, generally eta liquid is greater than, yes, eta gases. So this is the, yes, next go for the another slide for the, yes, the content preparation. So go for the previous slide. Previous slide, yeah. So please note down the property, and so thank you for your thank you for watching this video lectures.